There's so many variables to a great cup of coffee and a regular coffee. Not only does it start out with altitude, location, weather, soil, farming processes, but how it's handled and how it gets to us, and then ultimately what we do with it. A lot of the coffees that we choose have backstories, whether it's supporting women-owned and operated farms in Kenya or small indigenous communities within Chiapas, Mexico. It's not just the coffee that we deliver by the cup or by the bag, but the backstory is important to me. And the conversations that I have with customers about these stories is what makes it even more valuable. A gentleman came in, I introduced myself. He said he was looking for a coffee from Kenya because that's where he's from. And when I showed him what I had, which happened to be from the Kambari region, he lit up because he said that's where he's from. And his grandmother actually worked at that farm, and she got paid bonuses with every lot that she produced at a high quality. And that was the reason why he was here in the States going to school on the bonuses that she earned. So that's the closest it's ever come to me, because we always order these coffees with great hope that the story is what it is. But it was the first time I ever met somebody that benefited from it directly. The technology aspect of what we do is critical. It's brought these coffee farms in these indigenous places into South Dallas, or sometimes it feels like I'm there. And those relationships are very important to me because I can use video conferencing and connect directly with the farming community when it comes to making a selection or seeking offer samples based on what they have available. And if we are able to order quick enough, then we're able to source these coffees and keep the supply chain rolling, supporting their family and then supporting ours. And it is, it's one community.